Hello everybody, this is Dr. Taylor, and today we're going to talk about how to conduct an ordinal data analysis. Now, as you may remember, ordinal data is a categorical data type where the variables have a natural order to the categories, but the distance between the categories is either unknown, such as first, second, or third place, or the intervals between the scales are unequal. Maybe you have an income scale that goes from 0 to 15,000, and then 16,000 to 50,000, and then 51,000 to 110,000. Those are unequal intervals between the scales, and that would make it ordinal data. All right, so how do you analyze this data? Well, first we're going to start by identifying your ordinal data. And then we're going to go into step two, which is doing the statistics, creating the frequencies. And this time we're going to include median and mode, because we can actually use these descriptive statistics in telling our story. Then we're going to move on to step three, which is create an Excel file. And then step four, we're going to create the chart. And when we finish all this, you should have everything you need to be able to do your write-up and your presentation. So let's get started. The first step is identifying your ordinal data. Now, I have the data for the volunteers group, and I have pulled that up. And you're going to go through and just kind of evaluate the data and keep a note as to what's ordinal data and what's not ordinal data. So how often do you volunteer? 1 to 2 times a year, 3 to 6 times a year, once a month, twice a month, once a week, several times a week. Well, we have categories of data, and we have unequal distances between them. So yes, this one does qualify as ordinal data. So I'm just going to write that down in my notes, that Q3 is ordinal data. Now, check all that applies, our nominal, how many organizations, that's going to be ratio, somewhat disagree, this will be interval data, we'll talk about that next. We have more multi-response nominals. Are you more like, this is a nominal variable, gender is nominal. This is check all that apply, so this is nominal text. We do have income, and this is uneven intervals. As you can see, it's 25,000, 25,000, 25,000 in the interval, and then it goes up to 50,000, and then who knows how much it is there. So that makes it an interval data. So that's question 27, which is income data. And then this group has also created several variables. So we have how many organizations have you volunteered for? And it's 1 to 2, 3 to 4, 5 or more. So because we have this 5 or more, it makes it uneven. So that would make it ordinal data. So this one would be ordinal. And and there are others in here, and I'm going to let the group figure that out, what's ordinal and what's not. But for this video, I am going to focus on question 27, which is the income variable. So you might have turned this into smaller intervals. Maybe you've turned it into high, medium, or low income. That would still be ordinal data, but we're going to do the analysis on the income variable. So the next step is to determine the frequencies and include median and mode in our descriptive statistics. So we're going to do that by going to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies, and we are going to go to Income. What is your total income? We're going to click on Statistics, and this time we can click Median and Mode, because if you remember, in nominal data analysis, we could not. Median and Mode didn't mean much. All right, so continue. We want to make sure we have display frequency tables. I'm going to click OK, and this is what we get. These two right here. And sorry, this one's from earlier. But anyways, okay, so we need both of these, and I'm going to open an Excel file. And you should have your Excel file that you have for this project. And I'm just going to rename the bottom. This is question 27, income, so that I know later. And I am going to copy this. Oh, and I don't like it formatted. I like it unformatted, so I'm going to do the paste special. And we also need to make sure that we have the mean, median, and mode. So I'll go back and I'm just going to put that right over here. Again, I did it. Okay, and I'm just, for me, I highlight it because I know I need to use it later. All right. So when you're doing ordinal data, you have the frequency numbers. So that's important. It tells us what the count is in each one. We had a total of 55 people who answered this survey, and we have 9 who are missing and a total of 64 people who had started the survey. So in the percentage file, they're going to include this total. So everybody who took the survey equals 85.9%, and there were 14.1% of the people who did not answer it. Now, I want to report on the people who answered this question. So I'm going to use valid percent right here. So using valid percent, I'm not going to use the missing data. And I'm going to, just to clean up things, I'm just going to get rid of this cumulative percentage. So now I can go ahead and start changing my percentages. We want this to equal 100. So equal, I'm going to change this to a sum so that I can make sure that I do this. But I need to change this to percentage. Unfortunately, 14.5, 23.6, 16.4, 16.4, 21.8, 7.3, and that gives me 100. All right, so for the chart, I'm just going to highlight this. I'm going to hit shift. Oh, sorry. I'm going to highlight this. I'm going to hit control. And then I am going to start with step 4. I'm going to start to create a chart. So I'm going to go here. I'm going to click. I just need a 2D. Change the chart title. The plot area. I want the vertical value axis. I don't want any lines. That didn't work. Major and grid lines. I don't want those. And because this is ordinal data and there is a natural order to this, I don't want to rearrange these variables. I want to keep it like it is, and they can see, you know, it's kind of follows a bell curve to a certain extent, but we definitely have more people in the 25 to 40 to 50,000 range. But we do have a good bit of people that make over 100. So when you go to report this on your presentation page, you will have this chart. But then above it, you're also going to report on the median, which is 3. And 3 is 1, 2, 3. The median is between 50 to 74,999. So you would say the median is, you know, 50,000 to 74,999, and the mode was 25,000 to 49. So all you're saying is that the 50th percentile fell in the 50 to 74,999, and the mode was 25,000. So when they say median is 3, that is not a count. That is telling you what scale point it is. And the 2 is telling you it's this scale point. So let me know if you have any questions about that. But then you have everything you need right here to be able to report on your ordinal data. And so again, in order to report on your ordinal data, first, you identify your ordinal data, then you look at you create your descriptive statistics, including frequencies, median, and mode. Then you take that data and you put it into an Excel file to complete step 3. And in step 4, you create a chart. And if you've done all that, you should be good to go. All right, well, that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed learning about ordinal data analysis. I'll talk to you later. Bye.